when you think of the difficulties, the economic problems and the issues that Greece has faced during 2015, you might be somewhat surprised to hear the number of tourists that still managed to make it there and maybe return next year. Joining me is Elena Kountoura, the Greek tourism minister. Minister, good morning to you.
Good morning.
First of all, there's a lot we've got to get through, so we need to go at a fair old clip. The current disruption, or any disruption that's likely to happen to travel and tourism over the next few days because of anti-bailout disputes, what can you tell us about that? Are there going to be any troubles?
No, I don't think there will be any impact. I think that tourists unite people. Sad stories and sad events are really away, and we have to be more like respect to the human rights, and has to be priority. And I think that tourist has to stay away from politics and sad events.
Right, and when we talk about the obviously here at World Travel Market at the moment, everybody is, there's a lot of people talking about what happened in Egypt, the plane crash.
My condolences to the families. It's a sad story. I don't know what happened, but if for any reason it's terrorism, for me, no matter where it happens or no matter with who, it's a very tragic situation we are against, and we have to fight it.
We will come to your tourism industry in a minute, I do promise you, but the other area we've just got to talk about is this extraordinary migrant crisis,
yes,
that you're facing. Now, the Prime Minister, Alexis Tsipras, has been very strong in basically saying, Europe, you're not working. It's not working, hasn't he?
We do our duty as a Greek government. Europe has to do her duty as well and has to act with solidarity spirit. So for us it's very important everybody to know that it's not a Greek issue, it's a European issue, actually it's a global issue. These poor people, they don't want to go to Europe just because they decide one day to go. They just want to live in their countries. So we have to do our best to be able to go back home.
And a lot of them are arriving on your tourist areas, aren't they? In the islands.
This is very, very nice. It's nice that you're asking. All the tourists, they act really great. They brought clothes for the immigrants. They really support our try to relocate and make their lives, you know, better. And they're supporting also our islands. And we do our best to make sure that tourism will have no impact from the refugees and the immigrants.
Okay, now let's stick with your tourism, because that's your area. The new government is in place. The bailout is, or the financial aid is in place. So now you've got to get the tourists back, basically.
No, we never lost them.
This is the surprising fact.
Yes, actually 2014 was a record, 22 million. 2015 was a huge record, more than 25 million. Actually, what we did was to show the real Greece that tourism has unite people and didn't really go into the political confrontation.
So
there is stability, and also they have to trust us, and because Greece is a very safe country.
So what's your target for 2016?
Well, actually, we're very happy. The numbers are fantastic. We are already 25% from from British tourists up. And for next season, already we're 4% up. So what I want everybody to come and see my beautiful country. You should come and see my beautiful country.
Not only
Athens,
you
should see the islands. You should see and live with our culture and history. And then you will decide to do the next 20 years holidays only in Greece. Trust me.
You can see why she is the minister.
Thank you so much.
Good to see you, ma'am. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for inviting me.
Thank you.